So I haven't been showing you guys any of this little process. I just started it. But I bought this little candy machine out of my hometown, Parachute, Colorado. And I noticed in the background of the Facebook yard sale that it looked like my either middle school or elementary school. Turns out the teacher that had it, we went over and saw her with help from a friend, and it was in my kindergarten classroom. She was just using it to as a little reward thing for the kids, but she had those little plastic containers, and it wouldn't fit through the machine correctly. This one machine's more for like loose M&Ms or peanuts or something like that. Anyways, not sure how old the machine is, and I didn't show you guys the full process on this, but it kind of, here's kind of your separate pieces here. Top, then the glass goes, and then there's a little mechanism here, and then the pieces, there's two pieces that slide in here, and it really all mounts with one little post that goes up to the lock of the screw piece here. So it's really awesome how they build these things, actually. So when the guy's doing the maintenance, getting the money out of it, doing whatever, it's really be really easy to change any piece of it. All he would need is a flathead screwdriver and the key to our lid. The reason I have our little Moon Eyes Roadster here is I want to do a little display case inside the candy machine. I want to put my Moon Eyes Hot Wheels in here. So I want to make this Moon Eyes yellow and kind of paint it up like it was something from Moon Eyes. But I'm going to display the Hot Wheels in there. Not my idea. I stole it from the internet. But I liked it enough to do it. I went down to Ideal Distributors here in St. George, Utah, and got these things. So this is just a primer sealer. Self-etched primer can go right over the metal, give it a little scuff. And then this is my base coat, that's why I had this little guy. I took him down to Ideal, and we matched the color on him as close as we could get. And then that's my clear coat. This will last quite a while, but this, as soon as you put this thing in the bottom here and you click it and shake it up, that'll only last maybe 8-10 hours or something like that before it gets hard in the can, because it's adding the hardener in there. So anyways, those are what I'm gonna spray this with, and then get it back together. I don't know if I'll have our local pinstriper, Jeff Dastrup, pinstripe it, or I'll just stick some Moon Eyes stickers on it or something like that, but I don't want to get too deep into this stupid project, because it is a stupid project. But the paint does cost a bit, you know. Don't be surprised when you get down there and you have something custom color paint match. It's not the price of a Krylon can. But anyways, let's get to spraying this thing and get it together. I did take this down and sandblast it. It was red. I went down and had that done. I have my, it has a stand, you know, a big stand, cast iron base that I have down at Sandblasting Solutions as well, getting sandblasted. But we'll get those back and then get that back together. But as for right now, this is all I'm worried about. I'll paint the base later, but we'll get started here. All right, now on your clear, you're gonna take this little guy. You're gonna pop him in there. And that breaks the hardener in there. There's a little hardener packet. You just mix that up. We're gonna give this a little bit of time to dry. We'll get back to her. All right. So we got her down there. Gonna see our shine. Looks pretty good. We'll check her out tomorrow. Maybe do a little bit of an assembly on it. See how it looks. Okay, so we got some of our Moon Eyes parts here, little Hot Wheels, whatnot. And the best thing is, I get to open Hot Wheels, which I'm always a collector, so I'm always the guy that keeps stuff in the box, you know. Some of these are already open, so. But I kind of like. Stick this one. It's kind of a neat one. I don't know if I could maybe stick it in the back there. Peeled this sticker off my Suburban. Let's see if we can get it on here. There. Cool. Well, here's our little finished product. I like it. And there's a good reason for me to buy a bunch more Moon Eyes Hot Wheels, because she isn't full. I'll have to check around the shop. I might have more Moon stuff that could go in there. But pretty cool. I like it. Anyways, there's a dumb little project. And we'll get on the stand as soon as it comes back from sandblasting. Haven't got the stand back from sandblasting yet. I also have another base from a another gumball machine, but I don't have another gumball machine, but I'd like to do a couple of these in different, you know, themes. Moon always being one of my favorites. I don't buy a lot of their parts, but I buy a lot of their stickers.